Okay, so that brings up another question. You talked about advocating for others. What about when you need to advocate for yourself? Like if somebody struggles to persist on their own behalf, what do they need to think and discern in order to keep going?
Yeah, that's a great question. Also, it's an interesting because we're living in a day and age where because of the Great Resignation, people are kind of saying, I'm finally going to take charge of my life and my being, and I'm going to make decisions that are best for me instead of what's best for everyone else. And that's a transformational experience that's happening across society. And I think, you know, Monica, one of the things that people are doing are being inspired by others. They're seeing others willing to take that risk. So kind of like I talked about, willing to take that risk causes others to do that. So advocating for yourself, it's really important that you have people in your life who inspire that out of you, because oftentimes people will shrink back because the people around them, they feel like they can't break out and really do what's best for them because they're always trying to be mindful of appeasing someone else in their life, whether it's a boss, whether it's a spouse, whether it's a parent, whether it's a child, where there's all these other, who are important relationships, who are valuable relationships, but sometimes they aren't the ones who are the most compelling for you to be everything that's in your heart to be. So advocating for yourself, first of all, knowing what your values are. That's really the heart of when you're going to advocate and you're going to say, I'm going to choose me first, which isn't selfish. At least you're making decisions about you that aren't selfish. And you're going to say, here's what's most important to me. Oftentimes people haven't defined that in a really clear way. And that's why they can stay mushy on their unwillingness to persist and press for themselves, because they don't have that conviction of this is what's most important to me. And so that's an interesting dialogue that's happening around our society. My mental health is really important to me. My spiritual health is really important to me. My physical health is really important to me. My relationships, my emotional life, those things are important. And I'm going to choose them beyond appeasing others and just my financial life, which also is important to you, but we're seeing that shift and it really does help us feel secure, because that's another reason people are fearful of advocating for themselves, because it feels like I'm putting myself out there and there's no safety net. And if I stand up for me and all these people are not for that, then I'm left on my own. And being alone and being isolated is one of the greatest fears we have, unless it's because we're rooted in conviction and values. And then we'll find other people, once we step into that place, who share similar values, and all of a sudden we blossom because of that willingness to advocate. So it is really hard, but fortunately, if we have the right people around us, have identified those values, and are willing to go for that, it's really pretty spectacular how quickly we can find a new set of people with similar values and a like-mindedness that keep us advocating for ourselves.